News highlights from all over the globe. Tonight, the eyes of the world are focused on an event of international importance. America and Russia are locked in a gigantic struggle to determine, once and for all, the supremacy in the world of chess. We take you now to Berlin, where our roving correspondent is covering the final and deciding match in this exciting tournament. Take it away, Berlin.
Hi there, world supremacy lovers. America and Russia have pitted these two magnificent minds against each other in this thrilling and blood-tingling game of chess. The two gentlemen seated before me are the world's greatest exponents of the game of chess. This is the first time they have met, and are pitting their skill against one another. Now, by the way, the Russian has the advantage at this particular time. His opponent's queen is in danger, and it'll take a brilliant move to counteract this. By the way, the gentleman in the dark glasses is the American. This is indeed a tense moment as the world awaits his move. I'm not allowed to interrupt their concentration for an interview, but I will let you hear their breathing. Nothing compares with this for sheer action. Well, there's the chime, and that denotes the end of the official tournament chess play. You see, all tournament chess ends at 6 o'clock every day. They're being taken back to their hotel where they'll be locked up for the night. And now, back to Hollywood.
This week at the California Institute of Technology, Professor Harris Clayton announced the completion of a new mechanical brain. It is by far the most advanced of all man-made thinking machines. If this machine lives up to the scientists' expectations, it may well revolutionize our way of life. We take you now to Caltech, where our roving reporter will give you further details. Take it away, Caltech.
Hi there, brain lovers. I'm standing next to the latest creation of this modern electronic world. This is reputed to be the finest scientific machine yet devised, capable of outthinking any human being. As a matter of fact, in preliminary tests, the machine has proved the accuracy and rapidity of its answers with all difficult questions put to it by its staff. As a matter of fact, the professors at Caltech have lovingly named it Smarty Pants. And naturally, its tiny hairspring adjustments are so minute that they've been delicately balanced to 1/1,000,000th of an inch. I'm now going to test the machine's accuracy by putting to it a very intricate question. Tell me, Smarty Pants. A man-made satellite circles the Earth at a speed of 2,800 miles an hour, and the force of gravity slowly decreases as it pulls away from the moon's orbit. What is the ratio of the decreasing speed in relation to the density of the ionosphere, provided this speed remains constant and varies only 1/1,000,000th of a percent due to friction? It says, would you mind repeating the question? Now, back to Hollywood.